do we go from here?
Oh, good. Drive in straight. You can ask those security men. Dangle.
Okay.
Excuse me, where do we go to Dua Hall?
Go to Dua Hall?
Yes.
On getting to the bus stop,
yeah.
You ask anybody by the left, then they will show you the position.
Thank you.
Yeah. Straight. Go to the bus stop, person, baby. Straight.
Actually, I've been waiting here to take you to the venue of the meeting.
Oh, good. So those are not Zion retreat?
Yes, ma'am. We are gathered in the hall.
Oh, thank God. I hope I'm not so late.
Not at all, ma'am.
I addressed a group of sisters at Badagry this afternoon. So I have to come just to meet your whole program.
Actually, you are just in time.
Oh, thank God.
May I come in?
Yes, come and sit in the front.
by sharing our own experiences with them. I now have the honor of presenting to you the main speaker for this evening's program, Lady Evangelist Sharon Dupe Wajoye.
Sistema, between 57 and 65.
Thank you, my sister. You can sit down. I have been asking this same question wherever I go, but no one has been able to get the answer or even get closer to the answer. I am not up to 60, not even up to 50. Mm-hmm. Just last month, I clocked 40 years old. My physical appearance does not tell the truth of my age. I look older than my age, all because I discarded and disobeyed the instruction of the Holy Spirit given in those two verses of the scripture. The agonies I have passed through, the valley of the shadow of death in which I have traveled, the rivers of sorrow and the stream of tears in which I have swum, have completely changed my physical appearance and buried my true age. May you never see the sorrow I've seen.
Amen.
And may you never be deceived to disobey the word of God.
Amen.
It all started 10 years ago when I left the university and went for my youth service. I was neither posted to the north nor to the east. I was left to serve in my home state. Because I studied banking and finance, I was posted to serve in a finance company until the horrible adventure of my life began.
Youth Corps sent from NYC's office to this place. Is your director in?
You are welcome. He's in. Please, please have your seat.
Thank you.
I will meet you at the clubhouse this evening. And we shall discuss the matter in detail. Yes. Yes. 7 o'clock. Okay. I would like to meet that new lady you told me about. Yes. Okay. See you later. Okay, bye-bye. Thank you.
The lady is around. The youth copper.
Okay. Say nine.
Okay, sir.
Yes, come in.
Good afternoon, lady.
I'm posted to this company, sir, from the NYHC. I'm to serve in this company, so I've come to ask if there's still a chance for me.
You are?
Sharon, sir. Miss Dupe Sharon Wajui. I read banking and finance, and maybe my service may be needed in this finance company.
Well, yeah. No doubt we asked for someone who studied that from the NYSC. I'm sorry to say, we were not expecting them to send us a lady. We needed a man who could work tirelessly. This is a small company and really work really very hard here, around the clock, to create a good impression in the heart of the public. And our standard in this company is very high.
What makes you think I will not be able to cope with your standard of operation in this company? Not all ladies are lazy. Some are even more effective than me. Perhaps you may give me a try.
And if you fall below our standard in this company?
No lady on earth may be able to cope with your standard of business operation.
I like to work with staff who are so sure of themselves. You seem to be very bold and confident. You are welcome into our midst. I hope you enjoy your stay in this company.
Well, if you will meet with my own standard of operation. My standard is high, sir. And if not, I will only endure working here till my service year is over.
I hope you, this lady, won't give us too much problem here.
Well, if my standard proved too difficult for you to cope with, your company will have to endure with me, at least for my 1 year service.
Mr. Bamiche, please come in immediately. Yeah, thanks. You are welcome into our midst, Miss...
Sharon, sir. Dupe Sharon Wajue.
Yes, Miss Dupe Wajue.
Thank you, sir. Sir, you call this company a small one, but it is big.
What makes you think so?
Well, the bigness of a company is not the building or the fleet of official cars, but in its effective business operation.
Where did you come across that idea?
But is that not a fact?
Yes, but that has been our strategy in this company. For at least the next 2 years, we plan to concentrate on effective business operation.
But that is a business secret common with many serious-minded finance companies.
Yes, come in.
Good afternoon, sir.
Mr. Bamiche.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Bamiche. This is... Miss Dupe Sharon Wajue, a banking and finance graduate sent to us by the NYSC.
I see.
Miss Wajue, this is Mr. Bamiche, the director of operations in this company.
Good afternoon, sir.
Afternoon, you're welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Pleased to meet you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Mr. Bamiche, you would please take Miss Sharon round to the rest of the staff. You would show her our office and you would let her meet with the managers and let her know her appointments.
All right, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank
then
you.
We can go.
Yes, you can go. Yes. Thank you.
Yes, I was intelligent. I was sharp in reasoning and understanding. I came out of the university with first class. But there was qualities I got out of the university. I got saved when I was in Act 1. I loved the Lord and I served Him when I was on campus. I led the worship team throughout my stay on the campus. But the first mistake I made at the beginning of my youth service in that company was that I refused to reveal my true identity as a child of God. I did not show my born-again identity to that young executive. Yes, he only knew me as a very intelligent female copper. That was all he did. He knew I was sharp in reason, intelligent and understanding. My refusal assure him I belong to the master was a great mistake. I did not mention anything about the gospel or my being born again Christian. Yes, I did it on purpose. Because something terrible had just happened to me towards the time I was to leave the capital.
Friday. Lady.
Dupe.
Yes?
Bracken brought a letter. Check your table.
Hey. I checked him in his room, but I didn't find him. When did he come here?
Just a few minutes ago. Check your table.
Lady, I heard it from Helen that you'll be having a medical test tomorrow morning. Have you heard about it?
Yeah. Now. Dear Dupe, I write you this letter in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I know you may be caught unprepared for what I'm about to say, but I have strongly prayed about this and I received my conviction. Dupe, I'm sorry to say that I'm no more convinced you are the best partner for my life. I mean, I don't think I can be the best husband for you. This is what the Holy Spirit has revealed to me and has finally convinced me of Jesus. And I cannot be disobedient to the heavenly vision. I'm sorry for all the sorrow and heartbreak this might cause you, Dupe. I'm sorry, I'm truly sorry. Thank you so much for all love and cooperation since all these days. Let's obey the Holy Spirit and it shall be well. Wherever I go, I will always remember you. Thanks. Your loving friend, Akiola. What's the meaning of this? But Dupe, why has Bro Akin done this?
He said he doesn't think he could be the best husband for me.
Have you ever told him that before?
No, no. I've always told him that he's a gift of God for my life.
Odupe, why has Brother Akin done this?
He said the Holy Spirit. What type of Holy Spirit? What type of Holy Spirit talks to him like this?
I don't know why Brother Aki has done this.
And see. See what Aki wrote at the end of the letter. Your loving friend. Friend? Have I now become an honorary friend to Aki? Like
Dupe. Let's go and talk to with him. At least we will hear the actual reason why he has written this.
Oh, he said the Holy Spirit convinced him. No. This is disgraceful. I shared my love with no other man but Aki. Lady, how can he do this to me? Oh.
Come on, Dupe. I can't believe it yet until we've talked with him.
This must be a dream. This can't be true. I've never loved a man with all my heart. You know, I told you everything. After 4 years.
Let's go, Dupe. Let's go and meet him.
Yes, come in. The door is not locked.
It's inside. Come.
Aki. What evil have I done you? Aki. What evil have I done? Aki, for God's sake.
Listen, Dukwe, you did me no evil. God is my witness. You did me no evil. Absolutely none. Sit down. Sit down first.
Aki, you know I've never given my love to any man but you. 4 years ago, when you came to me when I was in part one, I prayed about it. For a long time before I knew that the Lord wanted me to marry you. And for 4 years, we have built our hope on the fact that one day you will get married. And now, Aki, now that the time is very close, must you do this to me? Must you do this to me, Aki?
Raki. This is too much for us to bear, you know that. You are both leaving this campus in 2 weeks' time. Why didn't you even allow her to finish her exams before telling her all this?
Well, I'm sorry about that. I have not finished my final papers also when I received the confession from the Holy Spirit. It made me unprepared too.
What Holy Spirit are you talking about, Aki? My parents have known you.
Mine, I've known you too.
Aki, this is the devil working. My parents, my relatives, they have all known you. You told me to take you to them. Eh? You have thrown my honor into the mud. This is unfair, Haki.
No, Haki, you have to consider this your decision again. Have a second thought over it.
I am doing exactly what the Lord told me to do, okay?
The Lord told you to do this to me, Haki. He told you to drop me. He told you to do me this great harm. I love you, Haki. You know that. I shared my money and the material things I have with you throughout our stay on this campus. I love you, Haki.
Listen, you don't need to recount all these things. If you know that it was really God who used you to do all those things for me, you can as well tell Sister Lady that it was your uncle who paid for my accommodation and my feeding on this campus for 2 sessions. Go ahead and tell her.
Haki, I didn't need that. Don't talk like that. I was only trying to tell you how much I love you. Lady, help me. I don't know what I've done.
Haki, I still insist that this is not fair.
Look here, Sister Lady. I respect you so much. The Holy Spirit said it is no longer the will of the Lord for me to marry her. Are you telling me to do what is contrary to the will of God?
No! Can you swear with this Bible that the Holy Spirit told you to drop me? Take this Bible and swear.
Give it. Give me that picture.
Whose picture is this?
You can't be asking me that kind of question.
Aki, who is this lady?
My junior sister.
That's not true, Bro Aki. I think I've seen this lady before on this campus. She's in the chemistry department. She's either in part 3 or 2 in the chemistry department. Dupe, look at the back of the picture. So, Aki, my love, from Yeti.
Aki, is this the Holy Spirit who has told you not to marry me again?
Now, Dukwe, give me that picture back. Give that picture to me now.
Dukwe, give him the picture and let's go.
No! He has deceived me. He's lying against the Holy Spirit.
Now, give me that picture.
No!
Give that picture to me now.
No, I won't. No. No.
Dupe,
leave me.
Dupe.
Leave me.
Dupe, you took the picture.
Yes.
You took the picture, Dupe. You took the picture. Yeah.
Fear that I was growing old at the age of 31
and that it might be too late for me if I didn't do something fast. The fear made me thought there is no point in waiting for any man in courtship. I decided I will not wait for any man who happens to fall in love with me. But all along, the Holy Spirit kept on ringing in my heart that Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart, and do not lean unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path. Because a child of God has disappointed me, I choose in my heart never to trust God concerning the matter again. I decided to walk in my own way and to lean on my own understanding. That was why I refused to reveal my identity as a child of God to that young executive. The burning desire to get married took hold of me. I forgot all of the wonderful promises of God concerning me. I even forgot He said His thought for me is the thought of good, not evil, to have an expected end. I forgot He holds my life in His palm. I forgot every other thing but to get married. Just to get married.
Sharon, baby. Sharon, baby. What are you thinking about?
Nothing.
Just thinking. No. Just tell me. There's something big in your mind. Come on, tell me. You know, a problem shared is half solved. Come on, tell me.
Don't bother me. You can't solve my problem, Frederick. Only the Lord can solve them, so don't bother me.
Good. We're saying the same thing. How about God? Easy me to solve your problem, you know.
How?
See, Sharon, everybody in this company is talking about your good and brilliant success in the university. Man, congratulations. Give me a hand! Congratulations. Give me a hand. You see the director? The big man upstairs, and he told everybody about it. He said you got first class honors in banking and finance. Man, this is worth celebrating. Don't you agree with me?
There is nothing to celebrate yet.
Oh, come on. Sharon. Oh. With your first-class honors in banking and finance, you could work in any prestigious bank or finance house after your service year. Oh, with what you've got, you could dictate your terms. Yeah, I tell you, And not only that, you could also go for MBA if you wish, or any. Miss Sharon?
Yes, sir.
Meet me in my office now.
Frederick, conference closed. Case dismissed.
Sharon! Yes, come in. So, congratulations on your brilliant success.
Thank you, sir.
You must have been a very hard-working lady on campus. First-class honors in banking and finance. No wonder.
No wonder what, sir?
On your first day here, you asked us whether we'll be able to cope with your high standard. So, I want to ask you, in your own view, have we been able to cope with your high standard?
Frankly speaking, sir, this finance company is one of the best in town. I've discovered that the business operation is far too advanced for me. I'm trying to cope with the high standard of operations. You stare at me too long, sir. You embarrass me.
Sharon. Where did you get your wisdom from?
God gave it to me.
Good. Then, how about working in this company? I mean, becoming our permanent staff with a full salary and all the fringe benefits attached.
I've never thought of that, sir. You will have to give me some time to think about it.
Do you have to think about that? You are a youth copper, offered immediate employment with a full salary. What do you have to think about?
Well, with my qualifications, sir, I have to look around and see if there are other finance houses or banks I can work with. Whose standard of operation will not be too advanced for me?
come on, child. Don't be too smart. No, you've just said that this finance company is one of the best in town. Look, we need you here in this company. Simple. Now, go and think about becoming one of our senior staff here in this company.
All right, sir. I will think about it.
Good. Now, let's change the topic. Please sit down. Sharon, when are you bringing your man to come and meet us here?
My man? Which man?
I would personally like to meet your man. I mean your husband, Mr. Wajoye. I'm sorry, but have I embarrassed you with that question?
Yes, sir. Because you already knew I'm not married and I'm not a divorcee. The first day I came here, you asked for my name. And I told you I'm Miss Dupe Wajoye. Wajoye is my father's name, not my husband's name.
Well, I'm sorry for causing you that embarrassment. Well, actually, I knew you were not married. I was just trying to be double sure.
But why?
You see, Sharon, I have noticed that you don't always feel happy. Sometimes you sit completely lost in thought. And even when you heard you got a first class honors degree, it didn't even change you. It was as if nothing happened. So I thought probably you had a problem with your husband.
Oh, no, no, no. No, sir. Thank you, sir.
All right. All right. You can go.
Okay, sir.
Sharon.
Yes, sir.
Your success worth celebration. And we shall celebrate it.
Thank you, sir.
Think you are doing? Come back inside and close that door.
I've got to go home and prepare for tomorrow's work. It is already 8 p.m.
I was talking to you when you went into that kitchen, and the next thing you did was to be walking out of this place without me finishing what I was saying. What do you think you are doing?
I'm sorry, ma.
I will repeat my words. I said, I sense in my spirit that you are already growing cold in your spirit. When I was praying about your case 3 days ago, the Lord ministered to me to tell you to surrender your case completely unto Him. Proverbs chapter 3, verses 5 and 6 say, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He shall direct thy path."
All right, ma.
Sit down. I've not finished. Sharon, I know how you are feeling. You are running up to 31 now, and you are feeling you are growing old. But Abraham was far much older, and Sarah was...
That was Abraham, Mama, and that was in the Bible days.
Sharon.
Mama, if you don't have anything to tell me, may I now go?
Sharon, do you realize that all that you are already changing in your spiritual attitude?
I still love the Lord.
Well, you may think so, because you have not really gone into any physical sin. But you are already backsliding in your heart. Trust the Lord for the right man. Do not lean on your own understanding. Only the Lord can give you the right man, Sharon. Wait for the Lord's right man. He will come. Sharon, never allow this present situation in your life to push you to get married to an unbeliever. I am praying for you.
Thanks, ma.
Sharon.
Yes, ma'am.
Experience has proved it times without number that it doesn't pay to be unequally yoked with an unbeliever. No matter the gentility, no matter the generosity, humility or sense of understanding, good morals are no substitute for salvation. Good night.
Good night, ma'am.
Hello? Is that Evans and associate? The estate agent? Yes. This is the managing director of Constant Rock Finance Company. Yes. Please, I'd like to speak with Mr. Lambert, the GM. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. Hello, Mr. Lambert, morning. Fine. And you? Good. Please, I'd like to inquire if you have a three-bedroom bungalow for rent. Yes, to rent out. You don't have one at the moment? Oh. A three-bedroom flat? A decent one. Where? Stadium Road. Okay, that's okay. Yes, we need it urgently. Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Okay, bye. Miss Sharon, please come in.
Thank you very much for the letter of permanent employment you gave me yesterday. It contains more than I expected, sir.
Well,
like you giving me a sudden and unexpected promotion to the post of the head of account section. And the salary grade level is higher than I thought, with the promise of an official residence and so on and so forth. Well, I think I will now stay in this company. The offer is high.
Well, the offer has to be high for a big fish like you.
Thank you, sir.
Sharon.
Yes, sir.
There is something that keeps bothering me, and I really don't know how to handle it.
Business matter?
Well, not really. Actually, it's not a matter for discussion in the office or during official hours. Can you come to my place later this evening?
I'm going to the church this evening, sir. We have worship nights.
No problem, no problem. Then I'll come to your place early on in the evening. Then I'll take you for the worship night. How about that?
Okay, sir. That's all right. Do you go to church, sir?
Yes, yes, yes. Sharon, what sort of question is that?
I'm sorry to embarrass you with that question. I'm only being inquisitive, sir.
Yes, I do go to church.
Every Sunday?
No. You see, I travel a lot. Actually, the major problem I have is I don't have someone to encourage me.
Your wife doesn't go to church? What
funny.
You make me laugh, Sharon.
It's not funny, sir. Your wife should encourage you to go to church. It's good to love the Lord and to serve Him.
Sharon, what makes you think I have a wife? You are dazed at my question.
You are the director of this company, a successful finance company.
So what, Charlotte? I am successful just because God made me successful. Just the way you got your first class, because God gave it to you.
But why? What have you been waiting for? You are old enough.
May I ask you the same question? You are old enough. Why haven't you not gotten married?
Well, mine is quite different from that. A brother let me down. You were supposed to get married this year. He dropped me and hooked another lady.
Then mine is not so different from yours, Sharon. Just a minute. She.
Who is she?
Lillian.
Lillian?
She dropped me last year. 3 months to our wedding.
But why?
I don't know. I just don't know.
Sorry.
Thank you.
But where is she now?
I learned she got married to a German. And she now lives in Auckland. And I've not seen her since then.
Sorry. The brother who jilted me really broke my heart. I will have been getting ready for our wedding by now.
Well, I believe God does allow these things to happen. Probably to give us a better chance.
Sorry, sir.
Thanks. Thanks.
May I go now?
Oh, yes, yes. Sharon.
Yes, sir.
Does our deal this evening still stand?
Okay. I shall be waiting for you.
All right.
Unbelievable. That he is not yet married.
coming here to tell me? No. But he said it's a private talk. Can God be wrong this way? Will he be coming here to tell me? What could be so private? Yes. The executive chairman of the company, not married. Coming here this evening to tell me something so private. Hey! But this man is an unbeliever.
Experience has proved it times without number that it does not pay to be unequally yoked together with an unbeliever. Never try it. Never.
He's so nice. He goes to church. He's so simple. But why all this, for God's sake? But why all these celebrations and confusions?
Sharon.
You're welcome, sir.
May I come in?
Yes, sir. Come in, sir.
Thank you.
Sit down, sir. Sit down.
Thank you. Sharon.
Yes, sir.
Why are you so restless?
Oh, nothing, sir. Nothing. You a big man. The executive director of a company coming here to see me, a mere company worker, in this shabby apartment, makes me feel somehow uncomfortable and temporarily embarrassed, sir. And apart from that, nothing else.
You should move out of this apartment by tomorrow. The company has already secured for you a 3-bedroom flat, a very decent one, and I have already ordered for a full set of better furniture with domestic and electronic items. Everything in the flat will be ready by tomorrow afternoon. Everything should be in order in the flat by tomorrow afternoon.
Come again, sir. Come again, sir.
I said, the company has just secured for you a new apartment, a 3-bedroom flat, furnished with better furniture and full domestic and electronic items. You should be in that flat by tomorrow evening.
I'm very grateful, sir. I'm very grateful. Thank you, sir.
Sharon, that's all right. That's all right. Please come and have a seat. Huh? I am here to discuss a very important matter with you. Like I said in the office. And I would like to go straight to the point. Sharon, could it not be that God allowed that brother to jilt you on the campus and he made Lillian drop me so that you and I could come together?
Come out clearly, sir. What do you mean?
I mean, Sharon, don't you think God is working something out between you and I? Since the first day we met, haven't you not been feeling something strange creeping in between you and I? Sharon, I'm talking to you.
I don't like interpreting dark sentences, sir. Why can't you come out more clearly?
All right. You are right. Sharon, I think you are the lady I've been waiting for all these years. You have all the qualities I desire in a woman. You are bold, courageous, wise, and intelligent. You asked for clear sentences, and I've given it to you. Come on, won't you say something?
But you know I'm a born-again Christian, sir.
That is the major quality I'm talking about. Yes, that is the quality you have. That is what I need, someone who will draw me closer to God. That is the real quality that has been absent in all the other ladies I've seen. But you are a God-fearing woman. A God-fearing woman who would encourage me to move closer to God. That is the real quality that I said I have not seen in all other women. I now know why God allowed Lillian to drop me. I think I know why. Yes. What do you say, Sharon?
I don't know what to say now.
Okay, no problem. I can give you time to know exactly what you would say. How about by tomorrow?
All right. We shall wait and see.
Okay.
Going?
Yes.
So soon.
Sharon.
Yes, sir.
I am tempted to tell you something.
Well, you have the choice of resisting the temptation or falling for it.
You're right. I choose to resist the temptation.
Oh, no. No, please. I want to hear whatever you have to tell me now.
Remember, Sharon, whoever my wife is automatically will become the deputy managing director of my finance house. We see tomorrow. Good night.
Spirit is telling me.
Yes. I know you are growing old. And that is what is making you fret. Sharon, I know you have the Holy Spirit in you. And he has been guiding you all this time. But Sharon, I am your mother. And I desire for you not only the ordinary best, but the real will of God. You have not answered my question yet.
What question again?
This man, who you say is so nice to you, generous, understanding, and so loving, who you say has promised you the seat of his deputy in his big finance company. Is the man a Christian?
Yes.
Born again? Regenerated and blood washed. I'm talking to you, Sharon. Is his name written in the book of life?
I've never seen the book. How can I know if his name is written in there?
Come on, Sharon, come on. You know what I'm talking about, don't you? Stop twisting my words.
And you too, stop twisting my desire.
Do you want the Lord to grant your heart desire and send leanness to your soul?
God is not wicked. Get that straight.
Yes, God is not wicked, daughter. But in Psalm 106, verse 15, I read that the Lord granted Israel their lustful requests, but sent leanness to their soul. If you desire violently what is not God's will for your life, then the Lord may grant you your heart desire, but send leanness to your soul for the rest of your life.
All right, Mama. All right. Go on. Come on. Go on cursing me.
Sharon, I'm not cursing you. For God's sake, I'm not cursing you, Sharon. I'm only warning you. Do not marry this man, however nice he may be, if you know that he's not a born-again child of God. Simple.
Even if he's not born again, you don't have to lose hope on him. The Lord may use me to bring him to Christ.
Oh, yes. I now get the trick the devil is using against you. Daughter, that is the greatest deception of the devil. Is that your secret hope? You hope to convert him after you both got married, right? Is that the secret of your present willful disobedience? You think because this so-called sweetheart of yours loves you now, you will be able to drive him round and round as you will? You think his love for you is strong enough to bow his knees at the foot of the cross? By the way, what gave you the confidence that you will be able to convert him after your wedding, if the fresh love between both of you could not do it now? Sharon, do not go to the altar with this man if you know that he's not born again.
Mama, but I love him.
Sharon. You are my daughter. I appreciate your patience. I thank the Lord for giving a beautiful, brilliant, and intelligent daughter like you to me. My heart is groaning for you. I don't want your life to waste away. I know you love this man, but is the foundation of this love rooted in Jesus Christ? Whatever the cost, you must pay for a beautiful, peaceful, and godly married life. For the moment you go to the altar with any man and stand before the Lord in holy matrimony, your destiny is sealed for life and probably for eternity.
Despite my dear mother's warning, the burning desire to get married had made me blind to the danger of signing married covenant with a man who was never regenerated by the blood of the Lamb. My saying yes to his proposal was the genesis of my sorrow. We eventually got married. It was a large societal wedding. The wedding reception took place in one of the largest and the most beautiful banquet hall in the city. The newspaper carried the events. It was even relayed on the television during the major news. My husband had so many influential colleagues. They all came in their elegant cars. My people were so happy for me, but my mother had a mixed feeling. On the second day, we traveled to Poland for a month's honeymoon. During the honeymoon, I made sure we prayed together. I used to do the prayers. Why he only said amen? Life was sweet and normal till we came back home from the honeymoon. But the truth suddenly began to dawn on me just a week after we arrived from Poland. Just in the middle of one night.
To be here. Who smoked it? came to it. Cigarettes in the kitchen again.
Is there anything the matter? You are unusually quiet this morning.
I found something on the floor of our bedroom toilet overnight.
Huh? What was it?
Cigarette. Half smoked cigarette.
Cigarette? On the floor of our bedroom toilet? How did it get there? Did you ask the houseboy? Maybe he took it in there.
Then, when I entered the kitchen, I sniffed cigarette smoke again.
Mm-hmm. Then I must be right. It must be the houseboy.
I trust the houseboy. It can't be him.
Why did you say that?
Why I knew it couldn't be the houseboy. I found this in the inner pocket of the coat you wore yesterday.
I'm sorry.
You told me you never smoke, Folu. I never saw you smoking before. Then how come this? You do smoke cigarettes, Folu.
It had been a long time since I had smoked last. I just tried it again last night.
But why? Why trying to smoke again if it had been a long time since you smoked last? But this is ridiculous, Folu.
Sharon, it's okay. I said I was sorry.
Moreover, since we came from Holland, I've been praying all alone. Every morning, I wake you up to join me in prayers. You have always been complaining of tiredness, backache, etc.
Sharon, don't go too far. You knew me before you married me. You knew I wasn't so religious like you had been. I told you I need someone to encourage me in the way of God. So you've got to paddle this canoe gently. Lead me on patiently. Hey, don't rush me, okay? Don't rush me.
We took the file home yesterday to treat it, but unfortunately we forgot it at home. Oh, you mean the director is not around? He has an appointment at the Ministry of Finance. You mean you are coming down here right now to collect the file? Oh, why can't you wait till tomorrow? All right, tell your men to come in about an hour's time. Yes. I will go home and bring the file. Yes. Thank you. Hello? Oh, you mean my husband? He's not around. Maybe you can fall back later in the afternoon. Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
Sign this document before you go.
Okay,
sign this document before you go.
Okay. Lizzie, yes, tell ma'am. All visitors an appointment to wait for me.
Okay.
I'm rushing down home now. I will soon be back. When my husband comes from the secretariat, tell him I've gone home to collect the central bank's documents.
Okay, ma'am.
Thanks. But he told me in the office he had an appointment with the finance minister. Or is something wrong with his health?
To look after the business operation. What have you come to do at home by this time?
But what are you doing at home in your night dress at this time? Folu?
Asking me that question in my own house?
Can I not be at my house at any time of the day?
But
what?
You said you had an appointment with Finance Minister at the Federal Secretariat.
Oh, yes. And I came home to rest after the appointment.
You came home to rest with this bottle of hot drink in your hand, Folu?
I was feeling feverish. So I decided to make myself hot inside with this bottle of drink. Sharon, what have you come to do at home by this time? Whenever I'm not around, you should be around. So now, go back to the office.
We had a call from the central bank about the document of the foreign currency we brought home yesterday.
What about it?
They are sending their men in about 40 minutes' time to collect it. So I have to rush home and take it.
Don't mind them. We'll give it to them tomorrow.
They said they are taking the documents to the governor of the central bank this afternoon, Folu. And our home must get to them in about hour's time.
Then don't worry. Go back to the office. I will handle them myself.
Folu, we can't joke with the documents. Or else, our company will be heavily penalized or even sealed up.
No. Go back to the office. I will bring the document to the office myself.
No! We are going to the office together. Give way.
Where do you think you are going?
Into the room, of course. I'm going down to lie down. When you are dressed up and ready for the office, you wake me up. We shall go to the office together. Why are you doing this, Folu?
Sharon, you must obey me. Now, go back to the office.
Am I your wife or your slave?
Make your choice.
Then, I am your wife. Let me go into my husband's room. You didn't tell me you smoke. Now, you forgot to tell me you are a drunkard.
Thank God you have known the truth at last. Do I need to hide anything from you again? Care for a drink?
Pig.
You slapped me?
Yes, you stinking rat. You rotten pig. I slap you.
How do you feel, baby? Sharing your husband with a rotten pig and a stinking rat. Tend to fight with ladies like us. Okay?
I'm a street fighter.
I have a brown belt in karate and another one in taekwondo.
And for your information, Folu was my boyfriend before you wedded him. I mean, I do know where you came from and snatched my boyfriend just like that. At least we have been friends for long before you strolled in. And let me tell you, your wedding ring can't kick me off him, okay? So you go and Sima. Sima, all right? Do you know what that means? You got to cool down, baby. You cool down. Well, I might not come here again. At least I'll give you that honor. But Folu knows where to get me when he needs me. One last warning, baby. Don't ever think of divorcing him. Because if you do, I'll come into this place and take over from you. Because I'm badly in need of him. Well, let me suggest something. We could both have him, you know. We could keep him here with you. And when Folu needs me, he knows where to get me.
My points now. The situation now calls for caution and wisdom. You do not do anything very rashly. Don't argue with him again, and don't fight with him so that you give no further chance to the devil.
But what can I do now, Mama?
Prayers. Prayers. The only solution is prayer. When things go terribly wrong like this after the altar, nothing else could be done but pray.
But I've been praying, Mama. You see, I've been fasting since yesterday, taking nothing except this water. I prayed throughout the night, and just in the middle of the night, it just bumped into my room and ordered me to stop praying. According to him, he said my prayer is disturbing his sleep. Okay, I tried to pray quietly. He entered into the sitting room again and tuned up the volume of the stereo set in the middle of the night, for that matter. What else do I do?
Pray, pray. When there is nothing else one can do in any situation, then it's better to pray.
But he is making it difficult for me to pray in this house. He's making it difficult for me to pray.
If he orders you to shut your mouth, he can't shut your heart. He can't close your heart. And if you can't pray loud, then pray right inside your heart. And if you want to shout, you go right out there in the jungle in nearby church and go and shout out your prayers. No matter what happens, Sharon, you just continue to pray, and you must continue to love your husband anyway.
Mama, I've discovered that he doesn't love me at all. In fact, I know that he has some ladies outside. Apart from that lady street fighter I told you of, he doesn't love me.
Sharon, what do you expect from an unbeliever who has no God to fear? He has ladies outside. All those are normal habits of unbelievers, Sharon.
But mother, I never saw all this in him before I married him. Sincerely, I never saw all this in him.
Yeah, children of the devil are sometimes wiser and more intelligent than children of light. He must have suspended his bad habits for some time just to help get you hooked, Sharon. Now, let's talk about the solution. Prayers. Pray. I am praying for you and him. And I've sent prayer requests to the prayer squad in the church for him. We'll have to continue to pray. And we'll continue to trust the Lord, you know, for his salvation. The Lord is able to change him, I believe.
That is it. I think it comes from some of his friends.
Okay, take it easy. Take it easy. I'd like to talk with him and probably pray with him.
Okay. Is he
there? Never mind. Just go. I'd like to have some calls.
Mama. Folu? Folu?
This way. Come on now. Watch it.
Such places. It was at the Alabaster Casino. Well, at least I have not violated the deal.
You can have the whole lot of him here.
Why I have him at the Alabaster Casino?
I've told you, you don't fight with ladies like us.
Lady?
You talking to me, woman?
Yeah, I'd like to have some words with you.
Okay. I'm all ears.
I just want to ask you a question, my dear. Do you have a home?
You think I come from inside a hole or from a tree?
No. No, I mean a home. I do not mean a house, a matrimonial home. You know what I mean, don't you?
No, I don't have that type of a home. I mean, I got me no brothers, got no sisters, no husband, I got me no kids. But mama, you know what I've got? Got me men friends, got me guys, got me cigarettes, lot of them. A lot of bottles of hard drinks in my apartment. What else? Yeah, I got me a 7 feet wide bed, you know, for my normal business. Have I satisfied you?
Well, this is my daughter.
Really?
My first daughter. Her name is Sharon. When she told me what you did to her, I said I will see you one day and then I will talk with you.
I know you have me. Shall we then talk?
Okay. First, you forgot to tell me your name.
Oh, my name. I'm Evelyn. But you know what my girls call me? They call me Reno.
Reno?
Oh, yeah. Reno. You know, because I'm a pop singer, too.
Evelyn.
Yes,
you are a very beautiful lady. Mm. And you talk so intelligently. I'm highly responsible. Well, apart from singing, what else do you do?
Oh, well, I'm a street fighter. A professional in karate. You know, and in taekwondo. I'm a free girl, too.
Evelyn.
Yeah, Mama.
There's something as a beautiful, hard-working and responsible lady like you could do.
Like what, Mama?
A responsible lady like you should get married to a responsible man with whom you will build up a good home and have responsible and well-bred kids. Beautiful boys and girls, at least three of them, who will call you Mother! Mama! Mother!
Yeah, you're right. I know I've come a long way in this wrong direction, but I'll sort of trace my way back, okay?
You can't do it by your own power, Evelyn. You need a supernatural power of God. You need someone with the power to help you build a good home.
You're a Christian, right?
Oh, yes, yes. And I'd like to share with you the goodness of God.
Hey, shh. I know what you're going to say. I know I can't help myself. I don't have the power to. I know we have missed it. And I'll trace my steps back. Okay?
Evelyn. Tell me what you know.
First time someone will speak to me in a sweet way, like this since I've been going the wrong way.
Tell me about yourself, Evelyn.
You see, I was a Christian until 5 years ago.
Why? What happened? Why are you in all this mess then?
My so-called brother. I mean, suddenly jailed me. We were in courtship for 6 years.
Evelyn, a man jilted you?
Yes, Sharon. We were in courtship for 6 good years on the campus. We were actually studying medicine together. I gave him all my love and he ran away with it. I was about to sit for my exam and our arrangement was that after the course, you know, we'll get married. But just as I was about to leave the exam hall, I mean, I heard a man say that he has run away with another lady. He actually got married to another lady. In fact, the news came just as I was going to the examination hall for my first paper. And the next
that happened to me, I found myself in the hospital. You know, for a good 2 years I was there for psychiatric treatment.
2 years in a psychiatric hospital?
So, even after leaving the hospital, I still wasn't normal. I couldn't go back to the campus. I couldn't go back to the school. He ran away with my love, all the love I gave him. And he destroyed my academic career. By this time, all my faith had dried up. I lost my father when I was in the hospital, when I was a little girl. That was when I lost my dad. And my mom died when I was in the psychiatric hospital. And my mother labored so much for my education. Mama, this is too much. I don't even remember all. The man who cheated me caused my mental problem. Doctor said my mother died just because of my problem. She actually had high blood pressure. Since then, it's strong. Vengeance swelled up inside of me. I began to sing at clubs, you know. And from there, I learned, you know, karate and taekwondo. And at times, I easily give my body for money. I know all along I was going deeper into darkness. I know. But I just didn't want to turn back. I know.
But Jesus Christ is still waiting for you to receive you back to himself. He will cleanse your life. Purge it thoroughly and make your life wonderful again.
But my academic career was destroyed.
Yes, Evelyn. Jesus Christ gave you life and you are still living. He can reconstruct in a more beautiful way. What the devil has destroyed, he surely can.
Oh. Oh, where for God's sake do I start now? I know I was singing for the devil. Oh, Jesus Christ, help me.
This is the day the Lord has been waiting for. He has been waiting for you all these years to come back to him.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. I've used my body for men. Men. I was a street fighter. A singer singing for the devil.
It's all right,
darling. I'm sorry, Lord. I'm sorry.
Please thank the Lord. He has brought you back to himself.
How can he forgive all my sins?
Mm-hmm.
I've sinned too much.
That's all right, baby. The Lord is good.
Oh, Lord!
Never mind, baby. That's okay. Come on, that's all right. The Lord has brought you back. And we need to thank him. Let's join hands to pray.
Okay,
let's thank the Lord for his goodness. Lord Jesus Christ, we want to thank you very much this evening for bringing back home a prodigal daughter of yours. Thank you so much, Father, for your love, your steadfast love. We now pray, Father, that you will establish Evelyn strongly back into you. Give her a good husband and a good home. Take care of her, Father. Thank you, Father Lord. Blessed be your holiness. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
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 Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Congratulations, Evelyn.
Thank you.
You are blessed.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Sharon.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Sorry. Have you?
Yes.
Do you know that you are very lucky indeed?
How do you mean?
You were jilted, quite all right. And you went so much astray. But the Lord has brought you back home by his mercy. So you are very lucky.
Please explain, Sharon.
At least now, you can look very well before you allow any man to take you to the altar. At least you still have a very good enviable chance. As long as you have not yet made a marriage covenant with any man before the Lord, make sure you get married to a born-again Christian. I too was jilted when I was at my final years on the campus. And the thought that I was growing old at the age of 31 made me rush to the altar with a man I thought was nice but knew was not born again. Evelyn, I am already in a dungeon. Only the Lord can pull me out.
Sharon, there is something about this man I wouldn't like to keep from you. A secret.
Ooh.
Follow your husband. He has a woman in Auckland. And the woman has two kids for him, two boys. One is 6 years old and the other is four.
Mama.
Gary and Gibson.
Mama.
Come on.
Sharon, another truth is that Lillian is the true executive chairperson of Constant Rock Finance Company.
Mama.
Hold on.
The real headquarters is in Auckland. Being handled by Lillian herself.
Shh. No noise.
But why is this man doing this to me? He said I'm the deputy managing director the moment I got married to him.
Yes, Sharon. He's just managing director here in Nigeria. While you are the deputy. I mean, Lillian is the real executive director in Auckland. Remember, anyone
can be deputy MD. And you know, he travels a lot. You know, Auckland. That's where he goes often. I mean, you know, he goes there to see his kids and to see Lillian. Mama, look, I'm not saying all this, you know, to destroy the home of your daughter. Mm. But, I mean, because the Lord has used you tonight, you know, to restore me back to himself. I mean, that's why I felt I should just let out this secret.
Thank you.
You know, I mean, in fact, I'll be sinning if I should hide it from her.
Mm. That's all right.
Mama, I just want to say thank you again.
No.
Thank you. Thank you. Cheryl, see you.
Thank you.
I have a good news for you.
Mm-hmm. What is it?
Hmm? I am pregnant.
Mm, really? Fine. When did you discover that?
You are not even excited about it.
What the hell do you want me to do? Hmm? To jump in the air and start dancing? Huh?
I do not expect you to dance in the air. But at least be so excited at the news of the coming of your first child. Your very first child.
Well, I'm excited about the news of the coming of a child into this home. But
hold it, Folu. Just hold it. I'm not saying you should be excited about the news of the coming of a child. So, get me right. I mean your child, your very first child. So, correct that statement.
Correct what?
Hmm? Well, I don't think you need to be excited about the news anyway.
What do you mean?
Because the baby in my womb right now is not your first child.
Who told you that?
Neither am I your first wife.
Where did you hear that?
Lillian is your first wife. And unknowingly to me, you have made me your second wife.
Go on, telling me about your findings.
Lillian gave you two boys, Gary and Jimson. Gary is 6, why Jimson is 4?
Have you finished?
Lillian is the executive chairperson of Constant Rock Finance Company. And she had the headquarters in Auckland, where you are merely the managing director of the Nigerian branch.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Go on, tell me more.
I have nothing more to tell you.
Then why do you go about wasting your time hiring detectives to find out about me?
Follow. Why? Why are you treating me like this? Why have you told me all these lies? I've never dreamt in my life to be a second wife. Why?
You don't want to be a second wife? Yeah? Then you can go away.
Where to? Follow.
Anywhere. You either remain my second wife or you go away.
Believe the Lord is in control. So, Mama, let's just be calm.
Thank you, Evelyn. I believe what you say. You will be without a job.
Yes.
I believe.
But, Doctor, how about the baby in her womb?
Madam, your daughter will be all right in a few hours. She will come round.
But
at least she's still alive.
So, the baby isn't alive?
Not that alone.
What again?
Her womb had ruptured.
Her womb ruptured?
That was what caused her severe internal bleeding.
Her womb ruptured? What does that supposed to mean?
Madam, we tried all our best to repair the womb. But it was, it has been seriously damaged due to the severe kicks and blows.
And so, Doctor.
I'm sorry, your daughter might not be able to conceive again.
But the horrible news
of the great damage to my womb cut her hands down. I was the first daughter, the only child with the highest educational standard, closer to my mother than the rest of children of hers. I came out of the hospital after a month, hale and hearty, but with no womb to conceive a baby in life. I was like an empty shell, a cow with no tail. And horrible fear gripped my heart that I'd become a lion with no teeth, a tiger with no bones. I returned home to my husband. I became more frustrated when I noticed he showed me no love. He was never sorry for what he has done. When I was in the hospital, he brought home ladies, and his business was going on fine. So he has never missed a thing by my absence. Then exactly a week after I left the hospital, what I had been fearing actually happened. It was one horrible evening.
You have not answered my question.
I don't understand that question. And I can't answer the question I don't understand.
But I think the question is quite simple enough. I said, what is now your next plan?
What do you mean by my next plan?
I asked you a question before you went to the hospital.
Before I went to the hospital or before you sent me to the hospital?
Whichever way it was. You were in the hospital, weren't you? And I was expecting you to come back with an answer. But since you came back, you have not said anything. May I have the answer now?
I can't remember any question.
Okay then. I will ask you again. Lillian is my first wife. You are my second wife. Do you accept to be a second wife or will you go away?
You knew it well that I love you, and I gave my love to you. You have stolen all the love I could have for a man. But unfortunately, what I expected to get from you, I did not get. You took all my love and gave me back hatred, sadness, bitterness, and insecurity. And finally, you took away the greatest part of my physical life. I have no one else I can call my husband. You are the only man I have. So, what else do you want me to do? Where do you want me to go? I can't go anywhere. Instead, I will be contented to be your second wife
Oh, what do you want me to do?
Aha! For the first time, you two have decided to hide something from me.
What's that?
The doctor. What did the doctor say?
But you've known that already. The kicks and the blows you gave me in the stomach had affected the baby. The baby is no more there. You know that?
Yes, I know that already.
Then what do you want again?
What else? What again happened? Dupe, I am asking you, what else did the doctor's report say?
Go and ask my mother. The doctor spoke to my mother.
Why should your mother have an access to the information I ought to know?
Fool. It was Mama and Evelyn that were in the hospital through house. You weren't there. So the doctor had to tell them.
And what was the report?
My mother is coming this evening. She will explain it to you. I can't say it, Folu. I can't say it.
You can't say it?
Folu, I can't say it.
You can't say it?
I can't say it.
Then I too can no longer live in the same house with a woman who has no womb. What do you want?
For you, please, don't do this to me. You sense you can no longer live with me. Please, for you.
Your doctor has told me everything, every darn thing. So it was your mother who gave him the permission to cut off the womb, eh?
No. That is not true. The doctor cut off the womb because it has been badly damaged by the kicks and the blows you gave me in the stomach. Can't you understand?
No. 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 I don't believe that. I gave you some kicks and blows. Right. But they were just very light ones. Not strong enough to cause any damage to the womb.
Ah, Folu. Folu, the kicks and the blow you gave me cause internal bleeding and great damage to the womb.
Okay. But who gave the doctor the permission to cut off the womb?
Folu, the doctor didn't cause the womb, but the womb had already been severely damaged by internal bleeding caused by the strong blows and kicks you gave me.
No, 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 you're lying. You're lying. You just said the doctor told your mother.
I said my mother was there when the...
Then go out of this house and marry your stinking mother.
What did you say, Fulu?
Are you deaf? I said, go out of this house and marry your own mother.
I can't understand, Fulu. I'm going away.
And I cannot live with a woman that has no womb. Do you know what you have become? Who do you think you are anyway? If you know what you have become useless. A barren woman is better than you. Your case is worse than that of a barren woman. At least a barren woman still has hope. But you have got no hope because you have no womb. And I cannot live with you. So get out of my house. I do not need you anymore.
I'm going away, Fulu. You have got all what I have already. You got my educational career. I step into your life as an intelligent, brilliant, hardworking, with first class honors in my discipline. You married me as a beautiful, hardworking, a complete lady with a womb, with high moral integrity. I lost everything right here in your home. And you want to push me out, empty and wretched. Why can't you take my life, Fulu?
Go out of this room now. Go and pack your boxes and get out of this room now.
You are joking, right? You are just making jest of yourself. I'm not moving an inch. You've stolen all I have, including my womb and even my love. You've robbed me of all the essential of my life. You will live with me by force. Yeah? You will live with me by force. You've got to manage my life like that.
Sharon, get out of this house or I will kill you.
Oh, that is what I'm waiting for. You've taken all I have. You can have my dead body too. Do you think that will scare me? Do me a favor, man. Give me that. You fool.
I? Fool? I won't give you death. I'll give you a taste of death. You are getting out of this house tonight!
No! I'm going nowhere! I'm going nowhere!
You are getting out tonight!
I'm going nowhere!
Stand up!
I'm going nowhere! You lie!
I will make you live by force!
I'm going away.
carry my equipment. Hold on.
You are joking.
Yes.
You are joking. You can't push me out. I'm not going. I'm not leaving. I'm not leaving this place.
All right. You are going out of this house tonight. And I shall make sure you leave with nothing. Nothing.
Go and do your worst. I'm going away. I'm not going anywhere. This is my husband's house.
I have told her to go and marry you stinking rat. And by the way, what makes you think you have the right to come into my house however you like?
Where is Sharon?
You rotten pig. You prostitute. You have teamed up with them, huh?
Where is Sharon?
You can go and look for her in all your toilets.
Mama, just be calm. Let me go and look for her in the room. This woman, eh? You wanna really kill her? I mean, but what's wrong with you? You know that this woman has just gone through a major operation. You really want to kill her? Follow. Follow. You slapped me.
This is exclusively a family matter. You keep out of this, you homeless dog.
Man, why are you doing like this? Why?
Woman, this is my house. And before I count to three, I want you to walk through that door and go out. One.
Mama, sit down there. You've come to see your daughter.
Two.
3.
Sit down, Mama. You might just stay there.
Out.
Look, Folu. Are you out of your mind? You've caused a lifetime damage to the womb of Sharon. And now you want to drive the Mama out too? You locked up your wife in the toilet like a prisoner. And now you want to send the mother out like a dog. Are you out of your mind? I mean, for God's sake, what's the hell with you? What's wrong with you? Now, Folu, the key. The key! Folu, where is the key to the room?
Lady Street Fighter, and you, woman, get this straight from me. That lady is not sleeping in this house tonight, okay? She's going out tonight.
My son, why are you doing like this? Why?
this, man? Why has the devil possessed you so much like this?
Look, woman, mind what you would say to me in my own house, right?
Follow you. The devil has used you to destroy all the valuable possession of a complete woman.
You have destroyed everything my daughter brought to your home. Everything.
Woman, take your hands off me now.
Why? You ruined her marital life and her academic life. Everything.
Take your hands off me, woman. Nonsense.
Mama.
Evelyn, yes. Don't fight with him. Look, just leave him alone. Leave him alone.
Sharon.
Oh, God. Sharon. Everything.
Don't let this happen to me.
Yes, ma.
Don't let this happen to me. No.
Look at Mama. Ooh. Look at Mama. Ah. Mama.
Truly, to the world of my husband, I did not sleep in that house that night. I was carried straight to a hospital. Here I was referred to a psychiatric hospital. I was treated and placed on drug for 11 months. But before I left the hospital, Constant Rock Finance Company had folded up, and Fulu had gone back to Holland to be with him here. even Lord. Daughters of Zion, trust God with all their hearts. And do not me until your full understanding. In all their ways, acknowledge Him. And He shall direct that path. My dear sisters, you are luckier than I. You have not yet smiled. There's still chance to make an amendment. I've never enjoyed my mental life than the holy moment with pains in Hollywood. The remaining 6 months was like hell on heart. I envy you, my dear sisters in the Lord. Wait for the Lord. Search out his mind. For whoever you get married to will affect your destiny for life and probably for eternity.